Okay, let's move to the second question. Multiverse. Okay, so doesn't the multiverse theory take care of the cosmic beginning argument?
The talk tonight was very limited in its scope. I was addressing only the two models that are featured in the movie The Theory of Everything on the life of Stephen Hawking and his wife Jane. I didn't attempt to address other versions. If you're interested in that, you can look at my lectures on the existence of God and the beginning of the universe, or if you want to read something, take a look at the article in the Blackwell Companion to Natural Theology, which I co-authored with the physicist James Sinclair, in which we go through the wide range of cosmological models that are available today, which attempt to avert a beginning of the universe, and show why these models that do not feature a beginning are untenable. Now, specifically with regard to the multiverse models, so long as the multiverse obeys what is called the Borg-Guth-Vilenkin theorem, which says that any universe which is in a state of cosmic expansion on average throughout its history, then even the multiverse itself has only a finite past and cannot be infinite. And it's for that reason that Vilenkin, Bohr, and Guth developed this theory against past eternal inflationary models of the universe, which featured a multiverse of worlds, which are bubbles of true vacuum in an expanding ocean of false vacuum. And they showed that this inflationary multiverse cannot be infinite in the past, but must itself have a beginning. In 2012, to draw this story back to Stephen Hawking again, there was a celebration at Cambridge University of Stephen Hawking's 70th birthday. And at that conference, Alexander Vilenkin read a paper entitled, Did the Universe Have a Beginning?, in which he surveys contemporary cosmology and the various models. And he concludes, none of these scenarios can actually be past eternal. And this lecture is available on YouTube. If you will look for that conference and Vilenkin's name, title of his lecture, Did the Universe Have a Beginning? And this is a very accessible lecture, which the layperson can understand, and will deal with some of these other models to try to feature multiverse scenarios.